Special thanks to TSASA and thanks to Kondal Rao sir for giving me opportunity and inviting me after long years. Coming to topic, anemia and heart failure. Anemia, as everybody know, it's a poor prognostic indicator in heart failure, and anemia itself can cause heart failure at the level of less than 5 grams per deciliter. But it's uncommon to be a sole cause for heart failure mechanism. Coming to the definition of anemia, as per WHO criteria, hemoglobin of less than 13 in men and less than 12 grams per deciliter in women. And as per NKF criteria, hemoglobin of less than 12 grams per deciliter in men and postmenopausal women, and less than 11 grams per deciliter in premenopausal women is considered as anemia. In most of the studies, this has taken as a gold standard for defining the anemia in various studies. Most of these studies, which has done to know the prevalence of anemia, made the criteria 11 gram to 13 grams as anemia. And all these trials, this says that prevalence of anemia in inpatients is 30% and 20% in outpatients clinics, in heart failure patients. And the prevalence of anemia according to the, in different stages of heart failure, in different functional classes varies from the 30% to 60% according to the different criteria used for the hemoglobin, different hemoglobin criteria used for knowing the prevalence. But as the functional class increases, the prevalence of the anemia increases. Especially, it's found in the stamina registry. The anemia prevalence varies 30% in the functional class 4. So, these slides show, as we know, the anemia is very much prevalent in the heart failure patients. But if you want to know whether this is really related to the risk of readmissions and whether related to the risk of morbidity and mortality, this study says the presence of anemia itself associated with the recurrent admissions in the heart failures, with the heart failures, and also it is, one study has shown this is also associated with the increased morbidity and mortality. So, this all studies shows with the anemia at the different stages, more the anemia, more number of hospitalization and less survival is demonstrated in all these slides, in all these trials. So, we have come to know it is highly prevalent and it is associated with the more morbidity and mortality. Also, it associated with the low quality of life and also associated with the recurrent hospitalization. So the next question arises, whether by treating the anemia, whether we can prevent the re-hospitalizations and recurrent admissions, and whether we can improve the quality of life, or we can improve the overall morbidity and mortality by treating the anemia. So before going to the proper studies about the various modalities of trials, I'd like to explain the various relation between the anemia and heart failure. As everybody knows, anemia aggravates the heart failure by different mechanism. As I said, anemia can cause, sole cause of mechanism in heart failure. We know anemia is a major contributor because in the presence of anemia, tissues are under-oxygenated. In the presence of hypoxemia, tissues are deprived of oxygen, anaerobic metabolism, and prostaglandins and endothelial nitric oxide, everything is generated at the tissue level, causes the vasodilatation, and all the system runs at the peripheral vasodilatation situation. So, peripheral vasodilatation makes the heart to work at the increased number of cycles per minute and increases the burden on the heart by increasing the sympathetic stimulation, heart rate increases, number of circulations increases, LVH occurs, and heart under more workload, and also this workload increases the heart go into the fatigue and further failure. In presence of other heart failure condition, this further aggravate the heart failure. And if you see the other mechanism, like the presence of heart failure per se itself causes the, aggravates the anemia by increasing renal dysfunction and peritubular hypoxia. And everybody knows heart failure is inflammatory condition. It produces inflammatory substances which acts at the hemopoiesis level and decreases the hemopoiesis production. And we know heart failure patients use the aspirin and anticoagulants commonly. So GI losses also common, and also ACE inhibitor beta blockers, they acted the erythroblast itself to produce the anemia and further activate this. And if you see the middle of this one, the common ground causes, they affect the hemopoietic system itself, they cause the anemia, and also they affect the myocardium itself. Like if you see the lead poisoning and chemotoxicity and everything, they suppress the hemopoietic system and also they suppress the myocardial activity also. So find the cause and the treating is important rather than just knowing that anemia only sole cause of mechanism in a heart failure. So what the anemia is causes? Anemia produces more symptoms and signs. And what are the different modalities of treatment by which anemia can be treated? By supplementing iron, by supplementing erythropoietin stimulating agents, and some newer modality of treatments. So coming to the each modality of treatment, blood transfusion initially considered as the main modality of the treatment in the heart failure. But as we know, the blood transfusion only gives the short-term benefit and it doesn't give the long-term benefits. And it's itself associated with a lot of complications like acute lung injury, hemolytic reactions, and infection, transmission of infection. So its role is not encouraging in all heart failure patients for the long-term benefit, but only short-term benefit, especially in case of severe acute losses only, it is considered as a treatment modality. Next, coming to the erythropoietic stimulating proteins in heart failure mechanism, this modality, erythropoietic stimulating agents for improvement of anemia is studied mainly in the chronic kidney disease patients. The initial trials like NHCT and Canadian trials were discouraging, but they have shown that increased thromboembolic agents, events and increased hypertension and thrombotic events are demonstrated in that. So they have discouraged the use of this in every patient. But at the other trial, CREATE, COIR and TREAT trial, they show that if you keep the target levels of hemoglobin at the lower level, that they have shown the clinical benefits. So similar thing contemplating in the heart failure, whether they can going to they can transform into benefits by providing the increased hemoglobin, and whether they can decrease the hospitalization, they are studying the various trials. Like stamina heft, they are studied in 319 patients over the 53 weeks in less than EF of 40%. But this has shown only little bit increase in the hemoglobin and increased exercise capacity, but clinically that not shown a significant trend to suggest the treatment modality. That's, but Red HF trial, next trial, is the largest trial. It has shown negative effects. Almost most of the patients, they are associated with the thromboembolic events are more and hypertension is more. Other reactions are also more, but clinical utility is not that much shown, that benefits are not shown. So ultimately, this thing is not suggested as the proper modality of treatment in heart failure patient like a chronic kidney disease patient. Coming to the IV iron therapy, I'm skipping the oral iron therapy because oral iron supplements in heart failure, that's shown to be increased only a little bit, 0.5 grams increase in most of the studies, and it's not shown significant improvements. But IV iron uses dramatically in presence of anemia and even in the absence of anemia also, it has shown a lot of benefits in improvement of the clinical science and quality of life in different trials like FAIR-HF trial. It has shown that endpoints of the NIHA functional class improved, and 6-minute walk test also shown significant improvements in the patient's performance. So in conclusion, they have said this has given this improvements, but morbidity mortality benefits are not proven. CONFIRM-HF trial is a largest trial. It has shown benefits similar to the FAIR-HF trials. So ultimately, recommendations based on all these trials shown, it has shown the clinical benefits in the form of the quality of life and also in the form of the recurrent hospital admission, decreased trend for the recurrent hospital admission. But it has not shown the mortality morbidity benefits. So ultimately, recommendation for these three things are given. But newer modality of treatment, as I said, heart failure is an inflammatory condition. It increases the hepcidin activity. So most of the newer treatments like monoclonal antibodies, special medicine, anticoagulants, they are targeted at the hepcidin, but they are in phase 1 and phase 2 trials only. They have shown some benefits, but the clinical utility of this is still questionable. This slide ultimately I want to place because we are cardiologists, but before that we are a medicine, good medical practitioner. So not only these iron, hemoglobin, erythropoietin, we just go through the clinical examination, see, find out the causes, find out the any melena history is there, do the proper examination, if required the perirectal examination, go through the peripheral smear, if according to smear, if megaloblasts are there, look for the alternative causes of anemia in like any other patient, you have to evaluate the heart failure patients also, correct that. So take home message, anemia is independent predictor of morbidity and mortality in heart failure, and anemia has emerged as a possible treatment target in heart failure. Erythropoietin stimulated patient is a major concern for safety in heart failure, should not be used as routinely in heart failure. For patient with a documented iron deficiency, intravenous iron supplements may be initiated to improve the functional capacity. Larger control clinical trials are needed for further information and therapy guidelines for the newer modalities of treatment. Thank you.